Hello and welcome to this special discussion on LiveMint.com. I'm Rahul Sharma. It's been just few months since Tata Motors was forced to move out of West Bengal. And now PepsiCo India find itself in a similar standoff situation at Sunk Rail near Kolkata, although on a much smaller scale. PepsiCo's snack food division Frito-Lay was allotted a 4-acre plot in the area. But the company has not been able to take possession of land because two small factories have refused to vacate it. We now have with us our correspondent Romita Datta with us. Romita, why is the West Bengal government bending backwards to accommodate these two small factories? Is it because of a threat of the Trinamool Congress and the ruling front does not want any fresh controversy in the run-up to elections?
You're absolutely right. The government is bending backwards because it doesn't want to take the bull by the horns. Instead, it wants to buy peace. These units might be encroachers, but government doesn't want to pick up fight with the opposition, and rehabilitating these two units would cost much less. And especially with this Tata Motors pull out fresh in the memory, where Trinamool Congress had the lead role to play, and this Trinamool Congress again planning to contest Lok Sabha election on the plank of land acquisition issue, the state government thinks it'll be wise to negotiate with the units individually and settle the matter there than keep this issue alive by picking up a fight with Trinamool Congress.
Also, talking about the rule of law, it's believed that the two factories that are there that are refusing to vacate, they do not have even proper rights over the land.
Right. The state government admits that, but at the same time, it is bending backwards to the extent of, deciding to give them space in an industrial estate that would be coming up there, adjacent to the food park.
All right. Talking about the area, Sunk Rail, which is near Kolkata, is Trinamool Congress strong in that area, and can they pull off another Singur kind of agitation if they so desire?
Trinamool Congress has won the Sunk Rail Assembly constituency seat in 2006, and the Panchayat Samiti is also under their control. And according to party insiders, the Trinamool Congress chief has instructed supporters to oppose this acquisition and to keep this issue alive till Lok Sabha election. But the way the government is dealing with this issue and going to the negotiating with the units, going to the parties and, deciding to compensate them or giving them space in the industrial estate, probably the Trinamool Congress wouldn't succeed to do another rerun of Tata Motors.
All right. Talking about the entire this issue, after Singur, you now have Sunk Rail. Isn't the left front worried that this will indeed be a big major blow to the image of West Bengal? And considering that, they were all gung-ho about making West Bengal an industrial hub, what happens to that image now?
The state administration has, geared up, and it has mobilized the panchayat, the district administration, the district magistrate. They're all working at it. They're all working at it to, negotiate with these two parties, because they realize they can't repeat their mistakes as it happened in the case of Tata Motors exit. So this time they are trying to outwit the Trinamool Congress.
All right, even though they're trying to outwit the Trinamool Congress, trying to negotiate, but at the same time, they're trying to accommodate also so that it does not become a major issue before the elections happen.
Yes.
Thanks a lot, Romita. Well, that's it from all of us. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.